One of the most requested videos on this channel has to be this one, where we will be learning how to take a sequence of images or render layers from a scene and composite them in Blender's compositor. I won't be going over super advanced stuff for this one, just to keep it short and simple, but let me know in the comments down below if you want to see something like that, and I'll share some of my favorite videos on this topic. Now, without any further ado, let's get into the video. Now, if you guys don't know how to use render layers yet, I'd highly recommend that you check out my video about rendering huge scenes in Blender for free. In method number one, it'll teach you the basics in around 2 minutes, so it'll be quick and you'll get enough of an idea about how to use them. Also, you should always try to render your animations as a sequence of images instead of directly rendering into a video file. And also make sure to use a format like .tiff or .exr instead of .png or JPEG due to compression artifacts, basically. I'll be using the renders from my alternate realities animation to demonstrate everything in this video, in the hopes that it'll be more beneficial for you to gain a practical perspective to this approach. I've also made an exclusive tutorial about how to composite these animations in After Effects on my Patreon page if that is something you're more interested in. Anyway, let's open Blender, delete everything, and head over to the compositing workspace. You first want to check this Use Nodes option, because only then Blender will consider anything that happens in here. Now, there are two ways in which you can go about compositing render layers. The first is if you have just recently rendered everything in Blender without closing it. And in that case, you can simply use this render layers node and change the view layer directly from here. So you can have multiple render layer nodes set to different view layers and then combine them. However, since we're using a new project to composite something that we have already rendered, we are not going to use this node at all. Instead, let's press Shift A and add an image node. Now click on this open button and navigate to where you have saved your render layers. Select all of your images of the sequence, and before you click on the open image button, just make sure that this detect sequence option is checked. You will then see something like this. It'll say image sequence right here, and you will have the option to set the start and end frames. Now let's press Shift, Control, and left click on the image node. This will bring up a viewer node if you have Node Wrangler enabled, and you'll be able to see a preview of your node in the background. You can always turn this on and off by clicking on this backdrop toggle. You can control this backdrop by clicking on the viewer node and then using the handles that appear. An even faster way would be to just press Alt V and V to zoom in and out, and holding Alt and middle mouse button to pan the image around. It's pretty easy to remember. Middle mouse button to pan nodes, and Alt and middle mouse button to pan the backdrop. Now, before we move on any further, I want to take this time to talk about the sponsor of this video, Skillshare. Now, don't skip just yet. Let me first tell you all the awesome things that this platform has to offer. Skillshare is a popular online learning platform which offers thousands of classes on topics including design, photography, fine art, animation, music production, you name it. So it doesn't matter whether you're a beginner, an intermediate, or a professional, you'll always find something new to learn about. I mean, you can even learn the thing that we are learning here, that is compositing. All you have to do is search for compositing, specify your class level and your preferred length, and you'll have thousands of classes about that specific topic. Now let's say I was getting into motion graphics and I wanted to learn After Effects. I could simply search for After Effects and then choose beginner, and I'll get personalized recommendations. I can suggest this class by Chris George, which is an introduction to After Effects and perfect for beginners who want to get into motion graphics. Now here's the fun part. The first 1000 of you to click on the link in the description or the pinned comment will get 1 month free trial of Skillshare Premium membership, so you can start learning that skill you've always wanted to learn. Now this is a limited time offer, so you better hurry up and get your hands on it as soon as possible. Okay, now I'll add the rest of the image sequences in. We want to first start off by combining the layers into a complete image. So I'll start with the ground and character layers. To add them both together, we'll be using a node called the Alpha Over node. Consider the first input as the base and the second input as the image which gets laid on top of the first image. So if you put the character in the second slot and the ground in the first, it'll put the character on top and vice versa. Using the same logic, let's take the houses layer and then put it in the first input of another alpha over node, and then put the ground layer into the second input. We'll see that it looks perfect. We'll then connect the output of this alpha over node to the input of the first alpha node that we added to add the character into this combination. As you can probably tell, I'm kind of working from the foreground to the background. It's just a random preference. You could also work from the background to the foreground if that makes more sense to you. You can work in any way you want as long as you realize which layers need to be on top of which. So we've added everything here. If we take a closer look, due to the anti-aliased holdouts, some areas in between the layers have been left transparent. You don't want this. So keep in mind while rendering the render layers, which parts will actually need a holdout and which ones won't. In this case, it isn't that severe, so we can get away with it if we use a dark enough sky for the background. So let's try to add the sky background now. I'm going to be using this sky image from pexels.com for this example. If you try to combine this sky using an alpha overnode, you'll find that the aspect ratio of the whole thing changes. You could crop it into size and make it work, but there's an easier way to do this. You just have to switch the inputs to get the correct aspect ratio first. Now you'll see that the background disappears, but we can make use of this factor input to tell which parts of the sky image we actually want to add with the background layer. If you check the alpha channel of the background layer, you will see a black and white mask. We can invert this and use it as a factor to mix the sky. So the black parts will use the first input, that is the background layer, and the white parts will use the sky. And this gives us what we want. To have more control over it, we can also use the transform node after the sky image and tweak it from there. However, in order to keep this video simple, let's just get rid of the sky completely and just keep it black for now. So far, we've combined everything into a whole image by using nothing but nodes. Now, what's great about this workflow is that you can do a whole lot of stuff after every step, which gives you a lot of control over each layer. So I can go to the foreground character node, which looks a bit funky at the moment, and add a hue saturation value node after it. Now, if you drop the value and increase the saturation, we can fit this character into the rest of the scene without affecting anything else. You can blur stuff, add glare, vignette, and other cool stuff by using different nodes. Take a look into the nodes in the Add Nodes menu to get access to all of the nodes that you can use to create and manipulate your composite in any way you like. There's a fantastic video by Daniel Kraft which goes over all of the compositor nodes, so you can watch that to get an overview of all of the nodes. After you're done compositing, preview the last node, and if you're happy with it, make sure you connect it to a composite node. Now set up your render settings on the right here, set the output file format to FFmpeg, container to MPEG-4, AVI, or whatever you need, H.264, high quality, etc. And then you can just go ahead and render your animation. Once it's done, check your output folder and you should have a video file of the finished composite. And that's how you composite animated render layers in Blender using its built-in compositing features. Now, this is not my general workflow for compositing videos like these. I instead like to use After Effects or DaVinci Resolve, but this is a really powerful way to take your animations to the next level. And sometimes you may not have any other choice but to use Blender. So if you felt that you needed to know about this workflow, I hope this video helped you out. Let me know if you have any questions by commenting down below, and I'll try my best to answer all of them. If I don't answer them, then you can assume that it has already been answered, so you need to check through the comments to get your answer. I'm sorry. Anyway, that's it for today's video. I hope you guys found this video helpful and or entertaining. If you did, then make sure you show your appreciation by liking this video and subscribe for more content like this in the future. Also, check out my Patreon page where I post behind the scenes and sneak peeks of new projects, early access to videos, exclusive tutorials, discounts, and much more. Now, that concludes everything. Thanks for sticking till the end. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.